Hey, what's going on? Michael from Bedell Property Management here. There's lots of talk about how everyone wants to plow that snow and make that dough, but I thought it'd be cool to do a video about how some maintenance and preparation will allow you to actually make that a reality. So let's dive in and chat more about this. So the big key to having a successful snow plowing operation is having working equipment. It sounds obvious, but you'd be surprised. Lots of us face equipment failures throughout storms, and it can not only be devastating to us and our bottom line, but to our clients and their ability to really want to work with us long term. So one of the best ways to make sure that that happens as little as possible is just keeping up on maintenance constantly. So some things that I've learned to do throughout the years is just take some time and go through your equipment and try and stay up on as much maintenance as possible. Throughout the years, I've tried making formalized lists and stuff like that, but we'll just kind of wing it and go through and just do kind of a visual inspection here. Obviously, this is something great to do at the beginning of the year, at the end of the year, but it certainly doesn't hurt to do it multiple times throughout the year. I'm sure as you can tell, there's lots of snow behind me. We just got 6-8 inches this past week, and obviously this rig behind me worked pretty hard. So it would make sense to just go through and see if there's anything that's missing or loose or needs to be improved upon or maintenance done too, because winter's not over yet, so undoubtedly we'll be doing more work soon, and if we can stay on top of any issues, it'll keep us out in the field making that money, plowing that snow, making that dough, instead of sitting on the sidelines not servicing our clients and ultimately having them find somebody else that's not us. So let's walk around here, just do a quick little visual inspection.
A great place to start is just looking at things, seeing if anything looks out of place or broken, you know, looking at these cutting edges, making sure they've still got life left on them. Something we did about a week ago is I noticed there was a little bit of play in the wings, and there's actually a couple bolts on the backside. They'll show you in a second here that came about a quarter, half turns, and just needed tightening up, and that took the play out of those. Just walking around here. All right, here's something that I'm noticing. You can see these hoses here. They've got the nice wrapping on them, but I think you guys can probably see there. They're touching these springs here, and that's going to cause some wear. So we may want to actually zip tie those on back out of the way there, just to prevent that from happening. So see, something I found that I got to address here before the next storm, because inevitably, like you said, winter will be back. You want to look at the back side here, make sure the cylinders are looking all right, making sure that none of the springs are broken. Certainly look to see if it's leaking any fluid, maybe even check it, see if it needs to be topped off. I know every year and a half, year or so, depending on how much we're using the plow, we'll take that to our dealer Weingarts and have them go ahead and change out that plow fluid. We had an oil change done about a week ago on the truck before the snow came in, that we were good to go on that. Check the tire pressure. Truthfully, not the biggest mechanic guy, but want to make sure everything's in working order. Your strobe beacon's working. We get to the back here, make sure you got shovels, snow blowers are working good. We snagged another couple pallets of walkway melt last week, so we got plenty of that for the store. I'm sure as you guys can see, you're going, Bedell, you got to wash your truck here. What's going on? Well, I was just out an hour or two ago putting some more salt down, and it was at the time about 10 degrees out, but it's supposed to warm up nicely today, so we may just have to do that here in an hour or two as it warms up. Go try and wash the truck down and take advantage of the fact that actually I've got an empty hopper here, so it'd be good to get all the salt washed out of that. It's good to do that as frequent as possible, and just stay up on as much maintenance as possible with these things. You run into stuff like the running lights worked on the back of the truck, but I noticed the brake lights weren't working except for the third brake light on the Boss Salter there. So they had to wire these up just to keep the rig moving. Even though if you stay up on maintenance, you kind of got to be able to go with the flow and work up a backup plan. And in fact, we'll talk about that in a minute. I think that's the second part of this, is kind of having a backup plan. All right, so see, I'm missing one of these screws right here on the Salter. So I'll have to swing up to Weingarts, get one of those. All right, so like you guys saw with me having to put together those extra brake lights so that I could keep this truck moving during the storm,
It's important to have a backup plan, and that goes beyond just some Tim Hortons donuts and coffee.
Part of being able to stay on top of servicing your clients is having extra things like extra snow blowers or an extra salter around, or even extra trucks.
Certainly a great thing to have, but not everybody starts there. I know we certainly didn't, and it's taken us a long time to get there. But there are other things that you could certainly do to have a backup plan for when things go wrong in your business, and inevitably they will when you're trying to service your clients during the winter. Even if you're lucky enough to have a big salt spreader like we are, or a couple of them, having something like this Echo RB100W certainly doesn't hurt. For us, it's just a backup plan, but it's a great starting point. We started with something very similar about 20 years ago, and ultimately it led to more work and us getting bigger units, but we still have something like this around the shop. I mean, in a pinch, I wouldn't think twice about grabbing it and getting out there and servicing our clients. At the end of the day, they just want the salt put down. Doesn't matter how pretty it looks necessarily, even though, shoot, it's a pretty good-looking spreader to me.
All right, enough looking at this dirty rig. Let's go get this washed up.
One eternity later.
So while having a bunch of equipment will certainly help you with the preparedness, or at least make you look prepared and allow you to ultimately service your clients and get the work done, equipment only goes so far. It's certainly always good to have a great team of people behind you as well. I know it's a tight labor market right now, so it's tough for a lot of us to find really great employees that we can rely on, but thankfully there's great groups of other contractors like we have over here at Echo Means Business, a real good group of people who actually care about getting stuff done the right way and learning from each other and helping one another out. So I think that's maybe one of the best things that I could offer up in this video, aside from looking at your equipment and having extra equipment, is really having a good team of people around you who believe in you and want you to win. So I want you guys to go ahead, comment below, and let me know, what have I forgotten? What works for you? I'd love to hear all of it, the good, the bad, the ugly. So go ahead, comment below, let me know, and take care. Be safe, treat each other well, and we'll catch you on the next one. Take care, guys.